Hello friends, I'm Dr. Ritu Sharma, working as assistant professor in Biyani group of colleges. Today I am giving lecture on income from salary. In my previous lecture, I have described the section 14th, which explain five head of income. First is income from salary, then income from house property, then income from business and profession, income from capital gain, and income from other sources. Now I would like to continue with section 14A, which explains that income which is exempted from tax, then related expenses are disallowed. Now section 15, which is the charging section of income from salary, it defines that all the item of salary are taxable on received basis and due basis, whichever is earlier. And arrear of salary, if not included in previous year, then is also taxable. Next, section 16, it is related with deduction. Mainly, there are two type of deduction given in this head. First is section 16, subsection 2, entertainment allowances. Actually, these allowances only available to central and state government employees. So, to calculate the exempted amounted for entertainment allowances, we have to calculate 3 points. So, least of the following amount is exempt. First, actual amount received as a entertainment allowances. Next, 20% of basic salary, and then maximum rupees 5000. Okay, then section 16 subsection 3 is related with tax on employment. If any sum paid by employee as a employment tax, then fully allowed it as deductions. Now section 17, which define the word salary. Actually, employer pays to employee in many forms like wages, salary, allowances, bonus, fees, commission, advance salary, provident fund, contribution to new pension scheme according to section 18 CCT, and other incomes which is treated as salary in this head. And according to section 17 subsection 2, perquisites. Perquisites is a benefit which is also given by employer to employee. Actually, it's a non-monetary benefit. There are mainly two type of benefits. Monetary benefits are called allowances, and non-monetary benefits are called perquisites. It is also taxable. Now, section 13. It is based on profit in lieu of salary. It's included all the retirement benefits and any compensation before joining the date and after cessation period, and any Keyman insurance policy is also taxable under this head. I would like to continue with HRA. HRA means house rent allowances. It's a partly exempted allowances. There are mainly three type of allowances. First, fully taxable allowances, then partly taxable allowances, and fully exempted allowances. But HRA is a partly taxable allowances. So, for calculation of HRA's exempted amount, we have to calculate three items. So, least of the following item is exempt for HRA. First is actual HRA received, then 40% and 50% of salary, and rent paid minus 10% of salary. After calculated the three items, least of the following amount exempt for HRA. Here salary means, for calculation the exempted amount for HRA, mainly three items included in salary: basic salary, DA if, means if DA is given as a part of salary and also treated as a retirement benefit plans, so DA then DA will be included, otherwise we will leave it. And percentage commission on sales. On all three items calculated as a salary, and for this salary is used for the calculation of amount exempted for HRA. And the 40 and 50% of salary means, if rented house is situated in Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Calcutta, then we will take 50% of salary, and other places then we will take 40% of salary. Now we can understand exempted amount for HRA through this question. Here is a question given: annual salary 70,000, DA 20,000, bonus 10,000, CCA means city compensatory allowances. It's completely taxable allowance. Next, commission on sale 1%, HRA 37,500, rent paid 40,000, and place of rented house is in Delhi. So, calculate for exempted amount for HRA, we have to calculate three items according to the rules. First, actual HRA. There, actual HRA is 37,500. Then second, 50% of salary, because place of rented house is in Delhi, and in this case we will take 50% of salary. And for salary we took we will take three items: basic salary, DAF, and commission on sales. Here annual salary given 70,000, DA given 20,000, but he has no information that DA is given as a retirement benefit. So, we will leave it. And the third, commission on sales is 25,000. Then salary will be 70 plus 25,000 is equals to 95,000. And the 50% of 95,000 will be 47,500. And the third one is rent paid minus 10% of salary. Here rent paid is 40,000 and 10% of salary, as 95,000 ka 10%. So 40,000 minus 9,500, it will be 30,500. According to the rule, least of the following amount, 30,500. It is the exempted amount, HRA. Now, we can calculate exempted amount for HRA like this example. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, comment, and share, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel.